してる時間はないんですが、私はあの、2010年、震災の前の年にですね、ここ実はある民間会社 の農業研修場なんですけれど、
And so I actually moved here in 2010, so the year before the disaster. And this was actually an agricultural training facility run by a private company.
そこ の管理人としてですね、あのここに入ったんですね。1年前で震災の。
And so I moved here 1 year before the disaster to work as the manager here.
であの実はここの施設にはあの水田だとか畑がたくさんあるんで、私は農業をやったことないんですけど、あの水田工作をやってみました。
And so actually I hadn't been involved in agriculture before that, but here in the facilities we have a lot of rice fields and agricultural fields and so on. So I came and for the first time was, you know, learning how to tend to the rice fields.
なのであの私の名刺はです、名刺にはですね、元飯舘村農民見習いとなってます。
And so on my business cards I have theFormer Itate Village Farming Trainee kind of written on my cards. One for each.
で、あの実は非常に飯舘村はですね、あのバスの中でもお話ししましたけど、あの自然豊かな村だったんですね。
And so as we mentioned in the bus, and you could see, Itate Village had very rich nature.
実はあの飯舘村ってあの経済的な統計から言うと。県でも下から数えて何番目なんですが、そうではないその貨幣経済ではそうなんですが、貨幣経済には現れない豊かさがたくさんありました。それはあの3世帯の構成だとかですね、あのこのここでいう自然豊かな村ということだったと思いました。
And so if you looked at the, you know, official economic statistics about the village at the time, it was actually one of the lower ranked sort of economically within Fukushima Prefecture. However, the real richness that was here is actually something which, you know, it can't be calculated in these kind of statistics, but it was the richness of the different, you know, communities or the families living together with different generations or the nature as well, rather than something that was monetized.
まあ、自然豊かな一つとして非常に花がたくさん、雪、これは雪です、雪が消えると福寿草が出てきて、水仙、まあ、ちょうど水仙は盛りですけど、アジサイがですね8月9月まで綺麗で、林道がで、例えばあの4月頃ですね緑の楓なんですが、これが10月になるとですねこんな風に紅葉します。
And so one of the things showing the beautiful nature here as well is really the flowers from each of the seasons. So you can see in the top left, even during the snow, there's these flowers coming out. There's also the hydrangeas, daffodils and so on. And also the changing of the leaves as well. You can see they go from this green to this beautiful red autumn leaves.
で、自然の恵みも豊かでですね、あのさっき見ていただいたフキノトウから始まって、あのウドとかタラの芽とかですね、こういうものがもう本当にふんだんに取れました。
And these are the kinds of other mountain vegetables. The one on the top left is the one that we saw before, or other kinds of things which grow in the hills, or really nuts and mushrooms and so on, these real natural things that were part of the life.
でここがですね、あ今皆さんがいらっしゃるのは ここのこっちの
So this is where we are now in Itate Farm.
で、1年間だけ米作りました。
And so they made rice here just for 1 year.
この1年間はですね、私にとってはすごく楽しい思い出がたくさんあって。
And I have so many fond memories of that year.
これだけ話すんだと本当に楽しい思い出なんですが、残念なことに1年で終わりました。
If I could just be talking about just that 1 year, it would be, you know, such a joyous thing to be able to talk about that. But of course, unfortunately, that only lasted for 1 year.
で、2年目の準備をしている最中にですね、震災が起きました。
And the disaster hit right when we were just preparing for our second year.
で、まあ、あの、電気が来ない、電話が、あの普通っていうのは予想できるんですが、普通の震災と違ったのは合わせて原発事故が起きたということですね。
And so after this happened, well, we could understand or expect having no electricity or telephone for a few days perhaps, but then it was when the nuclear disaster happened.
で、問題なのは、まあ、15日の午後が午後なんですが、放射性プルームが飯舘村を襲いました。
And it was after this, and actually the afternoon on March 15 was when things became serious, but this was when the radioactive plume covered the village of Itate.
それまではですね、陸の方から海へ吹いてた風が、15日の午後になって海から陸に吹き始めた。
And this was when the wind, which had been going out towards the ocean before that, changed direction, and the wind came straight for us here.
まあ、それだけならいいっていうか、大したことなかったんだと思うんですが、15日の午後から雨になりました。
And if that had been all, then perhaps it might not have been so serious, but from the afternoon of the 15th, rain began to fall.
夜は雪になったんですね。
And then snow after this.
で、この時点でですね、村の、あのモニタリングポストは 44.7 マイクロシーベルトパワー。
And the monitoring post in the village then read 44.7 microsieverts per hour.
おそらく、今日あの役場、あの最初によりました役場にモニタリングポストがあるんですが。
And you may have seen the monitoring post at the town hall where we stopped first thing this morning.
そこが 44.7 だとですね、おそらくこの辺は100マイクロある。
And so if that area down where the town is was 44.7 microsieverts per hour, then up here in the hills, it would have maybe been even, you know, 100.
それからあの今日長泥のゲート行きましたけど、あのゲートを下がりきったところに、高いところがあるんですが、そこはおそらく200から300ぐらいだっただろうと。
And in the area where the gate we went up to for the entrance of Nagadoro, which there's very high readings in some parts here, it's thought that the area just below there was probably even up to 200 to 300 microsieverts per hour then.
そうこうしているうちにですね、海岸浜通りの原発の立地自体、まあ双葉郡だけじゃなくて相馬郡からも来たらしいんですが、飯舘村に避難してきました。
And but what happened when this was all going on is actually people from the coastal areas from Futaba County and Soma County actually evacuated here to Itate.
で、3月21日に村の簡易水道から放射性要素がですね、900ベクレル超検出されて、22日から村はですね、飲料水を個別に配布しました。
And so after this happened on March 21st, from the waterworks here in the village, radioactive iodine was detected. And so from March 22nd, they started to distribute drinking water.
あの、それまではですね、いろんな情報を得て、自分で避難した人もいらっしゃいますし、村もですね、自主避難って言って、栃木県に体感を借りて避難した。
And so at that time, there were some people who, you know, looking at different information about the situation and so on, did decide to evacuate voluntarily themselves. And the village did actually also make some arrangements. There was a gymnasium which was rented in nearby Tochigi Prefecture next door, and where some people were able to evacuate to.
で、震災から1ヶ月経って国はですね。どうも飯舘村は放射線量が高いぞということで計画的避難区域っていう区域に指定して1ヶ月以内に避難しなさいと。
And then one month after the disaster, so on April 12th, because of the fact that very high levels of radiation were being detected, the national government finally did designate the city or make an order for it to be a planned evacuation zone. And then it was, people were given one month to evacuate.
それでですね、計画的避難区域を受諾したのは、まあ、4月22日なんですが、1ヶ月以内というのは非常に無理があってですね、結果的に村民が避難し終えたのはですね、6月末の7月上旬でした。
And so while the approval of this planned evacuation zone was made on April 22 and people were told to move within one month, it was not possible for everybody to be evacuated within that time.So it was actually not until sort of June or July that the whole village was actually eventually evacuated.
悲劇なのはですね、その間ずっと子どもたちが 村に生活してたってことです。まあ、割と子どもたちがいるうちは避難しなさいという指示は出てたんですが、放射能そのものについて全く無知ですから、何も変わりないじゃないっていうことでずっといたというのが事実です。
And so the biggest tragedy of what happened here is within this time, of course, there were still children, you know, living here in the village and being exposed to this radiation at the time. Many families that did have young children did evacuate. However, there was no knowledge or information available about radiation as well.
Itate 村はですね、実は地震に非常に強くて、今回の地震で一棟も倒壊してないんです。
And actually, Itate is very strong against earthquakes. And even though the earthquake did hit here as well, not a single house was collapsed.
この写真はですね、ちょうどそこのロッカーです。
So this photograph is this locker just here where we are now.
食器が飛び出したくらいですね。
And so the worst that happened was some of the plates and so on were broken.
で、実はこれが、まあこの雪がですね、伊達村を汚染した環境。
And so this is the snow which caused the contamination and the radiation of Itate. So this snow, this was on March 16, so just after the explosion.
で、実はですね、避難始まって仮設住宅というものができ
ました。And so after the evacuation was made, the temporary housing facility. So these two photos on the right are these temporary housing.
でこれまあ帰りがけにですね、また見ていただくと分かりますけど。
And after this, as we're driving, we'll see.
村のロケーションってこんなもんなんですね。隣のこれ実はですね、私写真撮った時に2軒だと思ったらこれ1軒でですね。大屋と納屋とか牛小屋とかなんですね。
And so you can see the comparison where on the left, that's where one family would have been living. You know, these two buildings, that's one family's home. So having so much space and then moving into what's on the right here.
まあ、これは狭くてですね、今まで3世帯で6人も5人も6人も生活してたのがとてもできない。せいぜい2人くらいしか入れないですね。
And so, you know, before people had been living with three generations together, you know, five, six or even more people in the family. But on the right, so each of those doors, that's one different temporary house. And so it can fit only a maximum of really two people. It's so narrow.
ですから、もう、伊達村では感じなかった生活のストレスが、もうもろに来てるというのが絶対です。
So it meant the real kind of mental stress, which people didn't experience at all in Itate was so present there.
村の復興、今はですね、国はですね、硬化した放射性物質を除染によって取り除いて、村民の帰還を進めると、まさしく来年3月に避難解除されてですね、いやおなしに戻らざるを得ない環境になるわけですけども、実際には、山林の除染が行われていない、今日見ていただいた通り、カウンターを持っていけばですね、すごい線量が。
And so, however, the national government policy is to be promoting repatriation or return of the villagers, and they're saying they're doing the decontamination for that purpose. However, first of all, the fact that 75% of the village is covered in these forest areas, you know, where decontamination is not and cannot be done, and there's also the situation now.
どうしても覚えておいてほしいんですが。震災前は 0.04 とか 0.05 マイクロシーベルトパワーだったんですね。そして今、
One thing that's important to remember is before the disaster, the levels around here were, you know, 0.04 or 0.05 microsieverts per hour.
で今ですね、1マイクロシーベルトだと、お、下がったねって低いねっていう感じを受けるんですが、とんでもない誤解なんですね。
But now, you know, when we look at the figures and we see one microsievert, we say, oh, it's gone down a lot, or it's quite low now, and so on. But that's ridiculous when we remember what it was like before.
これ、ここは、この232マイクロシーベルトパワーはですね、ここの雨どいの下ですよ。一番高い時で350ありました。
And so this on the photo on the left here, which has you know more than 230 microsieverts per hour, that's near the drain area here. And the highest, it was 350.
震災1年後くらいで除染する前です。
This is about one year after the disaster, before the decontamination work was done here.
で、国はですね、除染と称して、いろんなことをやってますが、民家の屋根に上がってですね、雑巾でですね、屋根の瓦を拭く、トタンを拭くという話なんですよ。これでは私はとても除染したことにはならない。
And so the national government is conducting all kinds of works under the name of decontamination. But we can see here, for example, it's, you know, climbing up on the roof and using a cloth to wipe down the roof tiles. And I don't think that we can actually say that this has been decontaminated.
水田の除染についてはですね、表面、先ほど見ましたけど、5センチを剥ぎ取って、5センチきれいな砂をかけると。そうするとですね、1ヘクタールの水田から約1000トンの廃炉が出ます。
And so in regards to how the decontamination of the rice paddies is done, you know, we can see this as we're driving as well. But so they remove the top, the 5 centimeter topsoil, and then replace this with clean soil from elsewhere. But that means for a 1 hectare rice paddy, it's 1,000 tons of waste soil comes out of that.
村の農地面積から考えると、400万トン。
And so if we consider this in terms of the overall area of the village, that's about 4 million tons.
それから実は先ほども言いましたけれど、飯舘村の緑、今はたまたま落葉してて緑がありませんが、緑の中には全部セシウムが入っているということなんですね。
And the other thing is, well, as we're going around now, you know, the trees don't have so much leaves and so on, but really all of the trees and the plants and leaves are containing cesium.
これはですね、震災後芽が出てきたモミジとかコナラとか杉の木なんですね。
And so these are different plants like maple and cedar and so on that their leaves came out after the disaster.
実はこの木の中にすでにセシウムが入ってる。
And there is already cesium contained in these plants.
ということはもう、自然の循環サイクルの中にセシウムが組み込まれたということです。
Which means that cesium has now been included within this natural cycle.
で、産業の復興、まあ、村としてですね、維持していくには産業の復興が必要なんですが、主要産業は農業とかですね、酪農畜産、それからここではちょっと出てませんが、林業なんか。で、農業はですね、例えば野菜なんかはですね、非常に競争力のあるいい品質のものができてたんですね。
And so, well, of course, in order to recover the village, recovery of industry would be necessary. But the main industry of the village here was agriculture, including dairy and forestry. Actually, the vegetables that were being grown here were actually very high quality, so very competitive on the market.
ところが、それはですね、先ほども気候の問題なんですが、昼と夜の寒暖差が非常に大きいということと、もう一つは実は土作りが非常に丁寧にやられて、酪農畜産で堆肥作って、で、山林の腐葉土を突き込むことでですね、いい土ができていた。
And actually the reasons for this were part of it was related to the climate, the very large temperature differences between daytime and nighttime meant that there was very high quality in the produce, and also there was very careful soil composition made, which meant that it was a very high quality as well. So working using, for example, manure from the dairy farms and mulch from the forest as well in the soil to make it a very high quality for growing.
酪農畜産は復活には時間かかります。牧草にセシウムが出てますから、まあ畜産の場合はなんとかしのげるのかもしれませんけど、酪農の場合にはミルクに出る可能性があるわけですから。
And so in regards to the livestock and dairy farming, it will take a very long time for that industry to be able to be recovered at all. Of course, the grass that's used for the cattle, and not only this, but the fact that, you know, dairy was put in milk to drink as well. So this means that it's going to take, you know, more than 100 years before that can be used and looked at recovering.
で、実は腐葉土を使おうと思っても、腐葉土が実は一番高いという結果が出てます。
And also, even if you wanted to continue using mulch within this cycle as well, it actually has the highest contamination levels.
ということをいろいろ兼ね合わせると、除染で村は蘇らないっていうのが私の、主張ですね。
And so when we consider all of these points, what I really believe that is, it will not be possible to bring the village back or to have the village be reborn through this decontamination process.
じゃあどうするんだっていう話になった時に、私は実は最初からですね、この震災が起きてしばらくして放射、正直言いますと、私自身はあの日 44.7 マイクロシーベルトの意味は知りませんでした。
And so, well, what should we do from now? What should be the path forward? But since the start, well, I mean, for me personally, when I saw or heard at first that there was, you know, 44.7 microsieverts per hour, I had no idea what that meant.
ただその後ですね、いろんな方がこう出入りするようになって、そのセシウムの半減期だとかいろいろ知るにつけてですね、とても簡単には蘇られないと。
However, after this, many people, you know, came for surveys or research and so on coming here, and you know, talking with them or learning more about, you know, what is cesium, what is its half life, and so on as well, really made me realize that decontamination will not bring the village back.
私はですね、当初から、仮説のストレスが非常に高いということは分かってましたから、仮説から復興住宅に住んで。ずまあそんな簡単にセシウムが消えるわけないので復興住宅に住んで、でセシウムが本当に減るのかどうかの様子を見て村に帰りたい人帰れない人決めればいいということをずっと提言して、飯舘村新天地を求める会っていうのを組織したんですけど、まあ潰れてしまいました。
And so, since the very early days, of course, knowing also the great stress involved in living in temporary housing, I was calling for people to be transferred to what's known as recovery or reconstruction housing. So it's sort of more permanent, still housing for people affected by the disaster, but as a more sort of comfortable permanent house. So I called for people to be moved there, and then we could monitor and watch how the cesium levels might change and evaluate in the future whether it would be possible for those who want to return and for them to be able to decide. And I launched actually, or I set up a citizens group which was calling for a new location or a new resettlement for people of Itate for that process, but that group is no longer active.
今国と自治体が住民をどうしようかというふうに見たときにですね、まあこれまで国内の年間被曝量というのは1ミリシーベルトだったと規定されているわけですけども、1ミリシーベルトには戻りません。
And so until now, well, what is the national and municipal governments trying to do? It had been said that the permissible annual exposure or extra exposure would be 1 millisievert per year, but it's clear now that, you know, it's not going to go down to that here.
で、戻らないということでですね、当面の目標をですね、年間5ミリシーベルトにするというふうに、村は、表明してます。
And so knowing that it will not be returning to under 1 millisievert per year, the village authorities have announced that the goal for now is to bring it down to 5 millisievert per year.
でもですね、一部では5ミリも達成できないところがあります。
But there are parts where it will be indeed difficult to even reduce to 5 millisievert per year.
ちょっと話あるんですけども、ここにいるとですね、だいたい 0.4 マイクロシーベルトパワーです。
And so when we're here on the farm, generally the average here is about 0.4.
で、村内で私が一日生活してるとですね、まあ今のところ農作業をやることもないし、山も入らない前提で、一日10マイクロです。
And so for me living here in the village, where, you know, I'm not working in the fields or going into the mountains and so on, it's about 10 microsieverts per day that I'm being exposed to.
そうすると年間 3.6 ミリくらいになるわけですね。
Which, if that's calculated on a yearly basis, that's about 3.6.
でもこれからですね、農作業をしたり、山へ入ったりするという話になると、とても5ミリを維持できない。おそらく で国はですね今福島に対応する 年間被曝量は20ミリシーベルト以下と言ってます。
And however, of course, if I was to start working in the fields or the forest again, it would go up to more than 5 millisieverts per year as well. However, despite this, or within this situation, the national standard that's being set for people is being 20 millisieverts per year.
で、環境省は私の質問に対してですね、タバコの害よりも20ミリシーベルト以下っていうのはタバコの害よりも低いんだと、仮設のストレスよりも低い。だから彼らは仮設のストレスがいかに過酷なものであるかということは知ってるんですね。
However, when I asked the Ministry of the Environment about this, well, they say, well, 20 millisieverts per year, that's less harmful than smoking cigarettes, and it's also better than the stress of being in temporary housing. But the fact that they say this means that they actually recognize the severe stress of the people in the temporary houses.
で、もう福島県内はこれが基準になって、いろんな自治体で機関進められています。
And this is already being set as the standards here in Fukushima, and repatriation or returning people to live in these areas is already underway in many parts.
で、まあ一部では1ミリシーベルト守れっていう裁判に出てるところもありますが、やっぱり福島県自体がそういう動きをしない。県はまあ正直、この20ミリ以下で動いてます。
And there are some people, for example, who are conducting lawsuits using the courts to try and appeal for the standard to be changed to 1 millisievert per year. But to be honest, the prefectural government, so which is equal to, you know, the state government, is, you know, honestly, well, it's just following the 20 millisieverts. It's not doing anything.
この先ですね、我々がどうなるかということを考えたときに、まず今問題になっているのは子どもたちの健康です。
So when we think about, you know, well, what's going to happen to us from now, the primary concern is, of course, the health of children.
実は子どもの甲状腺がんが増えていて、福島県、これ、2月ですね、こっちはフェブラリー、2月現在ですね、166人の甲状腺がんなり疑いがの人が出ています。
And, so...When we look at the incidences of thyroid cancer in children from Fukushima, we are seeing an increase. As of February this year, 166 children have been found with either confirmed or suspected thyroid cancer.
この分母はですね、38万です。
And this is of a sample of 380,000 children who have undergone these tests.
で本来子どもの甲状腺がんは100万人に1人か2人って言われていたわけですからいかに異常が大きいかということですね。
So it's said that usually the amount would be 1 to 2 children in 1 million would have thyroid cancer, but the fact that we're finding 166 in 380,000 shows such a higher ratio.
ただ県の健康管理調査という組織はですねこの166人の甲状腺がんとですね、今回の事故のによって放出された、要素との因果関係を否定しています。
However, the Fukushima Health Survey, which is, you know, the government organized or the government controlled survey which is conducting this, denies that there is any connection between these cancer rates and the radioactive iodine as a result of the nuclear disaster.
この辺は専門家でないんで分かりませんが、ただですね、低線量被曝の健康被害というのは、甲状腺がん以外にもいろいろ考えられているわけで、例えば高齢者の慢性疾患が促進されるとかですね、いろんなことが予想されているわけです。
And well, I'm not necessarily a medical expert myself, but one of the other things to, that we want to keep in mind is the fact that it's not only the thyroid which is affected by low dose exposure to radiation as well. And so also the link that this has, for example, maybe to the health of elderly and terminally ill patients or these kind of things as well is something that needs attention.
で、結果的にですね、私はもし返すとか、あるいはこれだけの被曝をした人たちに対する将来のですね支援制度まあ彼なんかその被曝手帳というような表現であれしてますけどこういったものが必ず必要なんだと思うんですね。
And so I think if we are looking, well, whether people return or not, but looking at their long-term, you know, the future support and situation of the people who were exposed to radiation, they really need to have full support and monitoring in place for this. And so one of the projects which Kentasana is involved in, having the handbook for people to record what, you know, their movements and so on, is one of the ways to do this.
で、今回の福島第二原発がですね、福島県あるいは立地自治体にどういう影響をもたらしたかって言いますと、まあ、1960年代後半からですね、導入が始まったんですね。で、確かに立地自治体は潤いました。あるいは周辺からですね、建設、原発建設に関わってここからもこの辺からもですね、作業員出てきた。しかしそれはたった40年間で、この事故でですね、受けたダメージはもう回復ができません。
And so if we look at what it was that the nuclear power plants actually brought upon this area on the community here, well, it was in the 1960s, the late 60s, that they were introduced to the area. And there may have been economic gains then, you know, for 40 years, maybe there was money coming in, and there were also jobs for people involved in the construction and so on, where people even from here were going there. However, that was just for 40 years. And when we look at what is brought upon us now, this is something which will not ever be able to be recovered.
確かに立地自治体は一時潤いましたけども、飯舘村はですね、全くそういう恩恵に良くしてないんですよ。
And however, while the local governments or the local municipalities in the places where the nuclear power plant is actually hosting may have benefited economically at the time, 飯舘 was not at all benefiting from this. It was not related at all.
そして飯舘村の人たちは全てということを全て奪われたということで、先ほども言いましたけども、負うべき責任が一切ないんですね。
And so the people of Itate, you know, lost everything. Everything was stolen away from them. However, they are not the ones who are responsible for this at all.
で、まあ、皆さんもすでに核災害に合っているということから考えるとお分かりいただけると思うんですが、まあ、原発事故、まあ、これは原発事故ではないですけども、原発事故でいうとソ連の麻薬から始まってスリーマイル、チェルノブイリ、今回の福島、ずっと見ていくとですね、実は津波とか地震が関係したのは福井市だけで、他はですね、人間がミスをした結果なんですね。
And so if we look at, well, of course, those of you who are here from the Marshalls or Tahiti, you yourselves know, you know, the impact of, you know, nuclear damage and so on. However, if we look at nuclear accidents or nuclear power plant accidents that have happened in the past, you know, look in the Soviet Union at the Mayak accident, Three Mile Island, Chernobyl, the Fukushima Daiichi accident is the only one that actually had an earthquake or a tsunami involved. All of the others, including Fukushima as well, were human error which caused these accidents to happen.
私はなんですが、原発というのはですね、今の陣地では制御不能なプラントだというふうに思ってます。
And so I personally very much believe that nuclear power plants are beyond any kind of capability of human beings controlling them within our capacity.
何よりも、ね、今日見ていただいた通りですね、撒き散らされたセシウムを回収する全く手立てがないんですよ。人間がですね、砂かき集めて袋に入れてという話なんですね。
And so as you know, you saw today as we're passing through the village as well, you know, how to recover from this, how to remove all of the cesium, you know, all it is that human beings are finding to do is we'll gather up sand and put it into plastic bags.
それからもう一つはですね、私今回の事故で本当に思ったのは、核災害というのは実は日本とか そんな問題ではなくて、世界の動きとしてですね、起きたらできるだけ早く風化させようと。例えば第五福竜丸の問題、まあ、マーシャル諸島ですね、第五福竜丸の問題をですね、今知ってる人がどれだけいますか。 でアメリカのですねウラン鉱山の廃鉱の被害がどれだけあるかっていうのがどう報道されてますか。セミパラチンスクだとかですね至るところみんな核の問題については封印されてしまう。今回の福島原発もほどほど対応にもう福島では若干あれですけども他のところへ行ったらですね何まだやってんのまだ避難してるのって言われる。そういう状態でですね、非常にこれは国とかの問題じゃなくて世界中の原発マフィアの問題だと私は思ってます、
And so I really believe that, well, if we look at nuclear disasters, you know, anywhere, this is not something that happens just in Japan, but around the world. Anytime they happen, people try to cover it up as quickly as they can. You know, look at what happened in the Marshall Islands. You look at the Lucky Dragon number 5, look at the nuclear tests. How many people actually know about what happens now? How many people remember this or are learning from this? It's always just tried to cover up so quickly afterwards. If we look at, you know, people being affected by uranium mines in the United States or other places, nuclear testing in Semipalatinsk, every time this happens, they try to cover it up. Even here in Fukushima, well, within the prefecture, people may still, you know, remember or pay attention. If you go to other parts of Japan, people say, well, what are you doing still living in evacuation? Or why are you still even talking about this? They try and put a lid on it and act as if everything's finished. And this is something not just here in Japan, but the nuclear mafia worldwide.
Thank you. ちょっと時間がなくなりましたけど、質問をいただければ。
We have maybe a few minutes now if anybody has any questions.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
ありがとうございます。
これちょっとですね、番外ですが、国と自治体がですね、どう我々に対してどうしたかっていう事実の一端です。
これ、汚染マップとですね、
スピーディーっていう放射能の汚染予測の図があるんですが、
So this is the map from the CDD data, which is the data which was used to predict the direction of where the radioactive plume would be going.
実はですね、これ自身が国民には発表されませんでした。
And so this data was available, but it wasn't announced at all to the public.
で、福島県庁には来てたそうですけど、サーバーのエリアがいっぱいだったんで消してしまいましたという報告でした。
And so it said that this data was actually sent to the Fukushima prefectural government, but because their server was full, the data was all deleted.
実はですね、これスピーディーの予測したものをですね、これは12日、3月12日から24日までの累積線量を表しているんですが、これとですね、これと汚染マップを重ねるとですね、実はぴったり一致するんですよ。
And when you actually put what was being predicted then onto the actual contamination map, you can see that it was exactly accurate.
で、これが報告されなかった結果どうしたかっていうと、先ほども言いましたけど、飯舘村はここです。ここの一部が非常に赤くなってるわけですけど、実はこっちの方からですね、ここへ避難してきたんですよ。それから例えば阿公木とかですね、対馬とかっていう飯舘よりももっと線量の高いところに大勢避難してきたんです。
And many people actually evacuated to places which actually were even higher radioactive doses than even here.
実際にはこれはですね、3月14日には米軍に提供されています。
And so this information was made available to the U.S. military from March 14th.
ですから国民の避難に供しないでですね、国民を被爆させたという意味では、私は国家的な犯罪だと思っています。
And so the fact that this information was available but wasn't told to the residents, but it was passed to the U.S. military, I think that this is really a state crime.
乗ってる間にもそのスピーディーについての記事が新聞に載ってるのがあって、はい、これをあの避難に使うか使わないかっていうことで信憑性がないから使わないって言うけど、実際このくらい精度が高いものだったんですけど、それを国は使わないという判断を実は国ものすごいお金をかけてそれを作ってるのに、その時莫大な予算を使いつつも使わないという判断をすることが自体どうなのかっていう非常に疑問に思う。
And so the fact that the government put so much money into developing this system, and then when they said, well, should we use the speedy data for deciding whether to evacuate people or not, they said, well, we're not sure how much, you know, accuracy or how much we should trust this data, so they didn't actually use it. So the fact that they put so much money into developing this, and then they didn't actually use it is... It's our taxes, you know, the way to use this. I think it's something even more, you know, it's even to be a loss.
まあ、はっきり分かったことは、あのお友達作戦で、あのこの近海に、あの、なんだっけ、空母がいたんですよ。
So as part of the sort of you know rescue operations after the disaster, there was U.S. military coming here in what was called Operation Tomodachi or Operation Friend. So they had ships which were based off the coast around here. And as part,
are U.S. scientists involved with any? Now I'm just maybe being a conspiracy theorist and thinking that they're just extending their human tests.
So
when we remember what happened or we look at the situation and we think about, well, is the government really looking out for the interests of the people or trying to protect the people's health? I think that's something really questionable.
Sakura?